In this video, we're going to show you step-by-step how you can not only identify a pump and dump before it even starts, but also how you're going to profit from it as well. Here we go. This is what's coming up, guys. What is a pump and dump? Why do they happen? We're going to give you where to find them and even how to get involved in said pump and dumps, and then talk about how to trade it as well. Let's jump right into things here, guys. Let's talk a little bit first off about how and why a pump and dump is happening.
Absolutely, Brandon. So, I mean, like, it's the description is pretty good one here. So a pump and dump is simply by whatever means. It could just be by excessive bidding or buying early. A particular stock is bought up, getting a large price movement to the upside, an order of magnitude more than a normal range of a day or two. And then you get that big move up. And then the dump means just immediately selling, right? So generating momentum to the upside, or at least appearance of momentum to the upside on a stock which has either been falling or it's stagnating. And then once you actually get that excitement and that buying, those that were doing the pumping are immediately exiting those shares. Sometimes it can be the same day. Maybe it's after a couple of days and you think there's a breakout happening. And then it is dumped by those that have started out that movement by buying it to the upside. And those that bought at the top by being tricked into thinking that the stock was getting a bit of a breakout are left holding the bag at those previous levels to the upside. So that's what a pump and dump is. Just to give you an idea of what that looks like on a chart, because you'll see, and usually this will happen in small caps, you're going to see like big spikes up and then immediate retracements, right? So usually you have a stock doing nothing or one that's actually in a downward trend, and then you get a big spike up, retracement, and then the recent one, which we'll actually talk about in the example of how you can profit from some of these, is this last one, almost immediately coming back to the downside, couldn't even get very far, guys. So a lot of things that we have to get into in terms of how you can spot them, but a simple pump and dump, guys, is about that big explosive move to the upside followed by an immediate retracement a day or two later, where you have a lot of bag holders left at the top.
Yeah, I want to go over a little bit about how to spot these things. And I think that we're very sort of, lucky to have good resources at our hands right now, including you could talk about Reddit. There's Wall Street Bets, obviously part of Reddit. Other sites as well that can show things like this Swaggy stock. And what this is, this just came from the birth of Wall Street Bets. And you can tell by the guy back here. And, you know, what I like to do is actually look at some of these names. And again, you just go to swaggystocks.com. This is not a paid promotion or anything. This is a site that I actually use. You can go to ticker sentiment here. And then it will say at the bottom here, which are the most popular talked about names on the different social media sites. And when I look on here, and we're going to get to this in a minute, but all of these names here, at least the first few, like Robinhood's IPO today, Tilray earnings yesterday and went like crazy, AMD earnings, Facebook earnings, Tesla with a big move today, Cliff Resources again with metal prices, GameStop's always here, Nikola today with CEO, new indictments, things like that, well, former CEO. Anyways, what I'm getting at here is that when you're looking on this sheet, if you're seeing names on the bottom here that have reasons to move, then that's not going to be a pump and dump. It's when you see names on here that are out of nowhere where we can't actually find news on them. I'm going to throw that back to you, Brendan, and maybe we can talk a little bit about that.
Yeah, let's get into the technical side of things here, because we're talking about where to find these and how to trade them. So if you're coming in the morning and your first check of the day is on Twitter, let's say, Twitter, a great resource to find names that are moving in the pre-market. But what if you find one, guys, that doesn't really seem to have any kind of news story attached to it? Maybe it's doing lots and lots of volume in the pre-market, millions of shares even, up 40, 50, 60 plus percent. And there's no reason why this seems to be happening. Those are the ones that we need to start paying attention to.
That's when your spidey sense gets tingling that you might be looking at one of those. And there's a couple of things you can go to here. And look, you can pull lots of resources out. But anytime you see something on a gap list like that, whatever screener you're using to see that up 50%, up 30% in extraordinary volume, a few things I want you to do first. And whether it's FinViz or Yahoo Finance, I'll look at FinViz. Just it'll show you what's the float. And that CHNR, by the way, that one that we talked about earlier, 13 million share float, so very low. Sometimes you look at the short ratio. That's not going to matter. Pump and dumps are a little bit different from squeezes, although the mechanics of, the moves might look very similar to a short squeeze. But for these purposes, let's imagine we're not talking about short squeezes here. So is it have a really low float? Okay. Why does it matter that there's a low float? Well, if a stock has a big float or a larger market cap, and we'll look at the, you can always look at the market cap, and you probably should as well. This is only a 54 million. It's because it would take a lot of actual money to buy and push up a more expensive stock, right? So you'd need some real buyers to want to step in there. I mean, large size, maybe institutional order flow coming in to buy stock up if that's a particular case. So in the absence of that, when it's a lower float, it's not going to take as much money to move it to the upside, right? So that's the first thing. If it's not the case, then it might not be a pump and dump. The second thing you want to look at, and I'll look previously before this thing, CHNR got moved to the upside. Look at what the average volume is. Go to Yahoo Finance, anything for historical volume. Look at a chart, put that in there, and see a stock that is not doing a lot of volume. Because that's one of the keys. Like if it has a very, very low average volume before that, and then suddenly it's gonna spike up, at least 40,000, 40,000, 50,000, a few days before where it spiked up out of nowhere and starts doing like 20, 30, a million shares on the day. In this particular case, a couple of back-to-back days of 3 million when it actually had the pump and the dump. You wanna see a stock that has almost no volume when it's hanging out in those lows, and then all of a sudden out of nowhere, the volume comes in to step up. And then, of course, I always do this. You have to pull up a daily chart because if you see a stock gapping, and this was an aftermarket move, CHNR, it's like, oh, big aftermarket move. This is going to be exciting the next day. Please look at the price history of the stock, right? Like, does it have a history of going up one day and then absolutely flushing the next day? Does it have a strong trend that you want to have be involved in, guys? So, yeah, maybe the stock has some serious support, but there's just so many spikes followed by massive decreases, right? So if I see that over and over and over again, that is another clear sign that you might be in trouble here. So when you come in and see those gappers, please go through those steps to check out the float, check out the historical prices on the stock, check out its previous volume to see if this is going to be sustainable.
Yeah, I just want to talk about now, exactly. So that's how you identify them and look for some good opportunities. I mean, you know, when we're talking about how to make money on pump and dumps, if you're not long initially, then it's almost like you can't make money on it because this is the big move here. I mean, look, this is the 1 minute chart. Like, let's go back. This is from, just right now, the 28th. So, you know, today's the 29th. So this is yesterday. So if you just scroll back, like look at the trading the days before, nothing happening, very limited. I know Neil just showed this. What I'm going to get to is here's the day where it started to go crazy. Like if you're not long on any of these levels, then it's going to be hard to make that money because by the time you finally figure out, this is in the very first minute of trading, guys. This is in the aftermarket. So now you're going to see a big bump up where you may not even have the ability to trade in the aftermarket here. But what, you know, a key thing to look for is when these start to go crazy is look for these even levels. So 50 cents up here, even $2 you could break long. And then look where it goes, only up to the quarter. So I like to think 50s, dollars, quarters, things like that, 75, some very, very key levels. And then honestly, you're going to have to go to your broker right away because if they have shortable shares, that's really where the money's made. Look to see big volume spikes like this candle right here, signaling that you may have gotten the top on this move. So big volume spikes followed by retracement, that may signal the top. So when you can get this at 217, 225, things like that, that's going to be a good short. And then because you already have your out, you have your out. So that's how you make money is that you take a risk on going short on something that's been pumped up. If you're not in early, take the risk and then use the previous high as your out. That's where I would try to make money on a stock like this, where it's out of nowhere, it's giving you a level, and then you hit that to the sell side. So I think that's the best spot, but remember, you gotta make sure that you're with the right broker. If you're not, then debate switching. If this is gonna be your style, you need to have the boroughs, Brendan.
Yeah, so we wanna find a stock that if you go out to the daily time frame has a history of those big one-day moves followed by multiple days immediately right back to the downside. And then once we see that top get put in, as Sean was saying, you want to start leaning on the short side there. Lots of great stuff, guys, on pump and dumps and how you can even profit from pump and dumps, guys. Here's Valeria.
Hey, guys. Thank you for this helpful information. Dear viewers, please subscribe to this channel to see more great videos.